Let's go to the guest line now and welcome on the crew chief for Daniel Suarez over at Joe Gibbs Racing, Scott Graves. They got to go through the first Dash for Cash segment of the season at Bristol, also the heats that preceded that. Scott, welcome to the program, man. It was a crazy weekend for you guys.
Thanks. Yeah, it was. Good weekend, but it was had a little more excitement to it, for sure.
You know, last year you come off 2015 with Chris Buescher as your driver, a very southern draw in Texas, before we even talk about Bristol. But when you go over to the Joe Gibbs Racing Camp and you're going to be paired up with Daniel Suarez, I have to ask, we've had him on the show a couple of times, was there any concerted effort on a communication trying to rebuild a relationship just verbally, being able to listen differently from Chris Buescher to Daniel Suarez?
Sure. I had to I listened to some radio conversation from Daniel from last year and just tried to get an idea of what it was going to be like. Obviously, we worked real hard on making sure that the radios, everything's working really well in the cars, so that everything's nice and clear and that we can avoid any issues. And so far, that's worked out pretty well for us.
Give us an idea of how the heats went for you guys at Bristol, because this was something new. You qualify, then the odd number qualifying cars go in one heat, the even number cars go in the other. You guys were eligible for the Dash for Cash money, but what was your thought going into that, and did it play out the way you expected it might?
Yeah, we obviously it was really important to qualify well so that we got ourselves in a good position, and then everyone was interested to see how the heats would shake out and who you'd be racing against for the Dash for Cash to be able to get into it, to be eligible. For Bristol, I think it played out kind of like what we thought. Everyone was looking at, what was going to happen there, if there was going to be a lot of passing or, how it worked out. But I think it worked out pretty close, worked out well for us. Obviously, we made our way in and we were able to race for it in the main race.
You know, one of the challenges you guys face when you show up to any track is you're usually one of the first series on the track, and Bristol's an extreme because the entire practice session, we're running around the bottom. You throw a little K&N practice in there on Friday night, but then realistically, you don't get an opportunity to run in a rubbered up track until later on in the afternoon when the race starts. Is there anything you plan on doing differently, or is it just relying on oats, or how's that work for you?
Yeah, it was a little bit more of a challenge. It seemed like this year even with the cup practice that was before us, they weren't really running up high yet. So we knew it was going to change a little bit, and we knew in the race that's where you're going to end up being. So we kind of went off, we got as much of a feel for it as we could in practice, and then went off notes as far as what we thought it would do when people were going to move up. But it was a little different. We knew for sure we'd be up there in the race.
Give us an idea now, after you've gone through the heat situation, you're going to be facing that three more times this year. Is there anything you might try differently without giving away trade secrets? Is there anything that surprised you about it?
No, I think, Bristol was kind of like what we expected. It's been harder to pass there recently, so we knew that qualifying was going to be a key there. Richmond could be a little bit different. It's a track that you do a 50-lap heat race there, and 50 laps in Richmond is a lot of laps on tires. And you're going to see some cars that might not be as good on a short run, but could be really good on a long run. So it's going to be a little more of a challenge finding that balance there. I could see it playing out a little bit differently at Richmond.
So you started eighth for a main. We go run 200 laps. You end up finishing sixth. What exactly did you need just a little bit more of to be able to go up there and contend with your teammates for the win?
We needed the outside lane on a restart, the last one for sure. I mean, obviously it went in our favor, I think the second restart before the end, and we were fourth on that restart and worked out in our favor. That put us in the spot to win the Dash for Cash there, and then that last caution came out at the end, and unfortunately we were in third at that point, which it's kind of odd to say unfortunately you're in third, but we knew we wanted to be on the outside lane, and just on the bottom there for that last restart. Didn't work out for us the way we needed.
Chatting with Scott Graves, the crew chief for Daniel Suarez in the Juniper Camry in the Xfinity Series at Joe Gibbs Racing. Tell us a little bit about what you think about Daniel Suarez after working with him for the first few races of the season now, because everybody seems to be really high on this guy, thinking he's going to be the next breakout star.
Yeah, he's, you look at the level of of experience and how long he's been driving this style of car. I've been really impressed. I mean, it's obviously this year we've gotten off to a really good start and had some good races, and we're half a lap from winning at Fontana and finished second at Vegas, you know, just behind Kyle there. So obviously I feel like we're close. We're knocking on the door. Just got to, you know, work on a few little things and have some things go our way. And I think you can see Daniel get his first win here sometime soon. So I've been really impressed with him. I've been impressed since watching him last year, and just doing my best to help him get that first win so we can help him you know, be as good as he needs to be here.
You know, he's running his third year in the series, but realistically only his second full-time year, coming off last year being his rookie season. Where is he growing the most at? Short tracks, intermediates? Is there any one area that, like, man, you're really surprised when you go to a track and you're amazed at the level of experience that he's showing for only being in the year in the series for one full-time year?
Yeah, I look at it as being a little bit everywhere. I think he's just, you know, the understanding of the racing, what a whole race takes, how to be there at the end. You know, I go back to even Daytona this year where, you know, last year I think he had been in some incidents at the speedway races, and we really worked on, you know, look, this year at Daytona, the goal is going to be to finish. We got to work on getting through the whole race without having any issues. And he did a great job of it. You know, finished there and car was cleaning up. All we really had to do was wipe it off and we're ready to go to Talladega with it. So, did a really nice job. And I think, you know, you take that and he's applied it to, all the other tracks we've been to as well. He understands the big picture, and I think he continues to grow there.
I mean, that's got to be a real relief from a crew chief's perspective to have a guy, a young guy especially, who understands that if you can work on making your cars better instead of having to rebuild them all the time, your learning curve is going to be that much more accelerated, right?
Yeah, definitely. Definitely gives us more of an opportunity, like you said, to keep working on the cars and develop and keeps everybody from getting behind in the shop, for sure.
You know, it's 2016, and one of the things that everybody's involved with at the racetrack and away from the racetrack is social media. We try every time when we get a guest on to find their Twitter handle, and I don't see one for old Scott Graves. How come that is?
There's one there. I just don't probably use it a whole lot, but I do have one.
Okay.
Just remember the golden rule, only happy thoughts on Twitter, right?
That's right.
Give us an idea. You touched on it a little bit earlier about Richmond, your thoughts going into that racetrack. It's still a short track, but obviously a lot different than Bristol. What are you guys looking for there? Because on the Cup side, at least, we've gone to all-day races there now. So what are you guys thinking about heading up to Richmond?
Yeah, I guess, you know, a little of the same. It's going to be a day race for us. The challenge, again, there is it's always, you know, trying to find the balance between turning the middle and keeping the drive off, especially later into a run. So definitely got that in our mind. Tire fall off is big there. So it's a short run car is good, but you also have to have a car that's gonna hang on and be there in a longer run. So it's a good, fun short track to race at. Track position is big. You got to run a perfect race. Can't have mistakes on pit road or on the track. So it's a challenge, but a lot of fun to race there for sure.
One more thing I wanted to ask you, Scott, before we let you go, is we ask all the guys involved in the Xfinity Series, and unanimously the drivers have said, yep, bring the Cup guys on. We want to race against them. When you've got a young guy like Daniel, I'm sure he's eager to race against the Cup caliber talent as well. Do you see it as a situation where they're stealing your thunder, or are you in the bring them on camp?
I'm in the camp of bring them on, because it's you know, we're trying to develop the talent for the future in the next, you know, the next generation. And you look at it and they're going to go to the Cup Series. They're going to have to compete against those guys. So it's a great chance for them to learn against some of the best drivers. And like I say, it's a good opportunity for them. I think they can learn a lot, and it keeps them hungry. I guess it sets the bar for them as far as where they need to be on performance. And I know, you know, Daniel feels the same way after talking to him. He's you know, he wants to beat Kyle, mm-hmm. To be able to race him and learn from him, and he wants to be able to go out there and beat him. So it's he's definitely looking at it from the same perspective.
There you go, Joey. It's still unanimous.
Exactly right. 100%. Yeah. Thanks, man. Appreciate you. I think it's a breakout star. I see qualifying efforts. It was your worst effort at Bristol. It's pretty impressive. First, seconds, and thirds up to that point. In your opinion, with the little tweak, what do you need to really finish this off and bring the victories back home for Daniel Suarez?
Really, it's just probably a little bit on the car side for us, getting balance a little bit closer where he needs it, and then execution in the race. Just like I say, no mistakes, and just all the little details. It's things that we're getting closer on every week, and a little bit more, and we'll get there.